think I'm going to keep this hand. It represents a turn 3 Karn, and it's also got the Dryad for the Titan, so. Depending on matchup, I can sort of navigate. Mirror. Okay, Mirror is tricky. Don't love this hand in the mirror. Definitely going Dryad over Karn. Okay, not mirror. Pseudo mirror. Oof. Discarding Karn here. I get got kind of by another Teferi, but I think I need to make this play just to come back from behind. If I don't start making things happen, you know, our opponent's just gonna overpower us. Expressive Iteration is fine. So opponent's probably playing a more grindy lands deck. They might even not be a Primeval Titan deck. They might just be a Dryad deck. I don't think we have anything in the sideboard for a matchup like this, which might be a problem. Yeah. Opponent is playing a very grindy game right now, which is good for us. Like, we want them to draw all their grindy cards and lands and not things like Dryad that just kill us and our things. Grazer is a good draw. I think we can beat this as long as they don't have. If they have like an ending in hand, we're probably done for. But if this is all they're doing, I think we're okay. Sequence this. Thank you. I just did that wrong. I was thinking I had enough mana to Titan here, but I don't. I'm hoping this prompts them to kill the dryad. It does not. Okay. Yeah, I missequenced that turn. Might still be able to do this depending on what their hand is. Teferi's a problem because it's likely going to bounce our amulet. Okay, this probably means they probably just have scapeshift. If they have scapeshift, we weren't winning. Because they were just gonna kill our Dryad or our Titan in scapeshift anyway. So it's not. Dead. I feel like we're dead if they're going to face this much. They have Teferi, so I don't know what they're waiting for. I don't know what they're thinking about if they have the kill. Okay. Yeah, we weren't winning that game. Okay, scapeshift. I don't know how much of a counterspell deck they are. They might have remands, but they might just be like ramp. I think this Radiant Fountain matters all that much. It could matter if we, like, fetch ourselves down to 18. Dryad seems important to what our opponent is doing, so I'll try two Force of Vigors over the Explorers. Also helps against like random sideboard cards. Shit. Maybe I'm supposed to hold a bounce land in hand there. Kind of feel like my mana is going to be important, though. Cracking map for Castle Garenbrig here? Probably. Very sure. You can bounce their own grazer? Target. Okay. Kinda interested in like getting my opponent to Spreading Seas of Cavern of Souls since we have a backup. Don't know if they will, probably not. Feel okay about our position this game. It's tricky because they can always just go pretty wild if they draw a dryad. Yeah, Teferi doesn't feel particularly great against us, but it can bounce a grazer. Not bouncing their own grazer. Yeah, it has to just be prime time here. As much as I want to start blowing up lands. Going to be Bring Delight for Valky. But that is okay. So hopefully we're not just dead. Hopefully they're just gonna like cast Primeval Titan or something. Interesting. Very interesting. Opponent can cast Bring to Light at instant speed right now. Okay. I kind of want to attack, get double Valakut, then Summoner's Pact and Transmute for a fetch land. My opponent will let me attack. You're allowed to attack. So we should play the saga first because, I mean, if they don't have an answer, they just die. And if they do have an answer, they have to play it in response to the dryad, into response to the Wood of Foothills coming into play. I think I just kill Teferi and Valky here. Or Teferi and Tybalt. So opponent might be like scape shifting for just to kill the Titan next turn. So gonna get Walking Ballista so that if my opponent scape shifts for value. We have the ballista. They have a Bring to Light they can cast. They have a Primeval Titan they can cast. Is this a Bring to Light? Okay. Probably another Valky if they have it. If they don't, then probably like Scape Shift or. Yeah, Scape Shift for value here. Thank you. a tight spot because they probably have another scape shift. And so next turn they probably just go land scape shift and we probably lose. Be funny if this radiant fountain ends up mattering. Yeah, but I mean, here they probably just go landscape shift, and we're probably just. That's probably it. Because they're gonna have two Valakuts, and then they only need three mountains to kill us. And we've seen 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 mountains, so they almost certainly have three left. There's an argument for, like, okay, so let's see. Our map's already gone. We're making, like, maybe we want to let this get exiled so that if we draw Karn, we can grab it. I don't think it, like, significantly changes the clock. And I think the chance of drawing Karn makes it worth it to let it get exiled. Right. I forgot our opponent had a Primeval Titan. I mean, I assume our opponent has two more mountains. It's like just so easy to do with all the triomes now. But I guess I will make them show us the two mountains. That is mountains. Okay, that's rough. I mean, we don't really have sideboard for a deck like this. We just kind of want to go fast, and our hands were just a little too slow. Yeah. I don't think I could have done anything different with sideboarding, really. None of the sideboard cards would have made a difference. Yeah, and I couldn't have done anything different with the Karn. Guess I could have Karn before Titan. If I Karn before Titan, get Liquid Metal Coating, I could hold up Coating that makes it so that they can't bring to light for Valky that turn because when the Tibalt enters, there's a trigger for the emblem, and then you can coding it in response. So maybe there's an argument for Karn coding that turn rather than Titan, just because, like, letting them get a Tibalt, which exiles a Titan, which lets them Titan, is just so bad for us. It's a lot of things to think about. Maybe I don't know. Maybe I was too cavalier with that Talaria West into fetch play. Maybe I'm supposed to hold that Talaria West. Do a play where I, like, go for Dryad, but, like, get just one Valakut and another Talaria West. Or even, like, a Slayer Stronghold. And then, like, they Prismatic Ending. They untap. They do whatever they're doing that turn. Probably exile my Titan, but then I get to untap and, like, go for Dryad Titan. I don't know. Or, like, Titan Haste. I don't know. That's hard. A lot of lines to think about. I don't think I played terribly. But any game where you resolve a Primeval Titan and lose, you gotta think about what you could have done differently. Alright, I'll see everyone next round.